Thank you. Rezesh.
And this is my logo. We also make posters, logos, and mascots. I love comics, and we are working on a new project.
This is my comic. And the comic is about Aphrodite and the island of Cyprus. I did it with a friend. It's not yesterday. I enjoyed this work very much. It wasn't something tedious. It was something very fun to do. Original. I like it very much.
Hello, my name is Naya.
The comic is about Aphrodite and Muse of Homage. I was the one who drew the comic, but my friend here did the script, because she was the one who liked the story.
So why do we have you with the power work?
This is my costume from the comics CD. This is my logo. Everything is written in kind of color. This is my Mona Lisa and Leonardo da Vinci in the fashion show room, which I really like making. These are jobs I really like to make. And yeah, this is a song. Thank you.
Yes.
From now on, we prepare our participation to international events. One movie festival and one international comics festival from France. Yes. Thanks for our prize. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed my short movie. And I want to ask our partner from Cyprus, yes, to continue with their presentations.
Dear partners, dear students, my name is Antonis Antonio. I come from Cyprus and I represent my school. I'm the coordinator of Erasmus project. This is my fourth time in Portugal. I am very happy to be here with you today. Before I start, I would like to thank the team here in Bahario for an excellent organization and for their warm welcome in this school. I will start with the presentation about my school because I'm sure the students would be very much interested to know a few things about our school in Cyprus. The name of my school is Regional Gymnasium of Elipatia. It's in Larnaca, which is a city near the beach. And the school is very close to the main city. Students from different villages around the area, students from Livadia, Roglin, Druli, Pila, and Gelia. And this is the villages basically, it's a regional school. We have around 480 students in our school from 12 to 15 years old. We have 65 teachers. We teach languages. We teach mathematics, history, physics, other science subjects. We also teach arts and music and gymnastics. We are very proud to have a special unit in our school where we have some students. And I'm happy to tell you that they are involved in the Erasmus project and they have produced some work for us, which I'm going to show you later. It's our special team. We have students from other countries. Around 10% of our students come from countries in Eastern Europe, And we have students from Iran, Kurdistan, North Africa, former USSR countries. And now we have students also from Syria and the countries where they come as refugees in our country. Our school is considered to be a school who has students with from low economic background. We run charity programs to help those who are in need. Of course, we organize concerts, theaters, performances, and other competitions. We have mediation programs in our school where we help students to mediate and solve problems. We try to eliminate bullying and violence in our school. Of course, we plan some excursions for our students to try to make them happy. And we run other field trips for occupational guidances. And of course, we have theater workshops for teachers. And this is our team, some of our students and teachers. And this is my colleague Miltos. You met him in previous meeting with his group of students working in this project. And my colleague Eleni is here with us today, working together with our students. And these are our angels from the special unit who work and produce some work for our project. So, I will start. I will ask one question to the students. Is any one of you knows how to play Minecraft? No. Do you know how to play Minecraft? How many of you know how to play Minecraft?
Yes.
Okay, you. So, we decided to use technology in our project. Since I am Microsoft Innovative Expert Educator, I decided to introduce Microsoft Minecraft in our school and in our project. And we asked the student to produce some work to create comics using Minecraft. So we had two different groups. They work. The first group, they created the story with an English teacher. And the second group, they created the story using Minecraft. And I'm going to show you now their work. The story is Holiday Adventure in Cyprus, and I will show you now. What is this? Cyprus. They arrive at the airport. Oh, you have a slow internet, I heard you. Yeah, no
That's why I told you to bring all the products. Support.
So they're right, Langa Airport. They're a bit confused, but they're happy they arrived in Cyprus.
Nu uitați să dați like, să lăsați un comentariu și să distribuiți acest material video pe alte rețele sociale.
So, one of them is very sick and he wants to go to the doctor to visit the hospital. So his brother will take him to the doctor, to the hospital. And this is the story. And now he visits the doctor. The whole idea here is to create scenes, to build the buildings using Minecraft. Grandfather with his grandchildren, and they have a conversation. is coming.
Beavers are the animal that He knows how to build in the rivers. And we took a picture to show you with the team. And we will now work together to create the stories and the comics other students create with arts teachers and language teachers to create this in 3D graphics using Minecraft. So the teams will work together, and this team will create their work in Minecraft using 3D graphics. Some more photos from the language class, how to use comics to teach a language. Some example with our teacher. Okay. Now, I will call my colleague Eleni to present you some of our work. We have two stories which we have created. Lenny, please.
Hello, everybody. My name is Eleni Kosti. I am a mathematician in the school. And this is the work of some of our students. We were called to present in comics some legends and traditions of our country. So we chose two. The first one is a subject that is presented in the literature and history lessons of our school. It's the Yenisa, Gridas, and the Saracen. The literature teacher presented the story first during the history lesson. Then it was easy for the students to create the story in English. Okay? So, the name is Akridas. Akridas comes from the word edge, Akri in Greek. And these Akridas were soldiers, former soldiers of the Byzantium during the 11th and 12th century. And they were old soldiers that after leaving the army, they moved to the edge of the Empire of Byzantium, and they were given land, and they moved there with their families. They were given land, but they had to protect the borders. Saracens, they used to attack the borders of the Byzantium Empire. So the Yenisa Akridas was the most famous of the Akridas. So the legend has it that the Yenis, the Yenis, these are some of the creators drawn by the teacher, Andreas and Stella. I forgot to mention these students, sorry. This is Andreas Georgiadis and Stella Georgiou. They were the two students that made this project. So, Akridas, these are the Akridas drawn by the students. They had a battle with the Saracens, and one of them escaped, and the Yenis saw him leaving the island, going down, leaving Minor Asia, and going to Cyprus, so he chased him. And afterwards, the Saracen hid behind the mountains. So the Yenis tried to climb over the mountains of Cyprus. He put his fingers on the mountains. And thus the legend has it that created the five hills you see on the mountains. And the mountains are called since then Pentadactylos, five fingers. And then the Saracen escaped, and the Yenis continued chasing him. And when he found him, he tried to kill him by throwing a stone. His wife stopped him. and the Saracen got away. So these are the stones. They're near Paphos on the south west of Cyprus. They are called Petra du Dejanin. That's the Dejanese rock. It's a legend. And until now, you can see them. It's in the same spot where Aphrodite arose from the sea. This is a job created by Andreas and Stella. They're 14 years old. The other one, it's a story, a legend. It's part of our religion. It's about St. George and the Dragon. I think you can find it in the Catholic Church as well. Okay. This is the four girls who created this comic. It's Ioanna, Georgia, Avgi, and Maria. They also go to the third grade. They are 14 years old. So the story begins with Tommy as the cat saying the story. It's based again on another subject of the curriculum. It's a religion study. The teacher there introduced the story, so it was easy for the students to create the comic afterwards. Tommy explains the story. It talks about the dragon that came into the land. And didn't allow the river to go down the stream, so there was no water. So the king called for someone to go and see what the dragon wanted and why did he stop the water coming down the mountains. And the dragon said that he said that he wanted to be given every year, every year a child from each family of the region. And so the king made the command, every family should give one of his child. And when his turn came to send his child, his daughter, he sent a word asking whether there would be anyone who could fight the dragon away. So St. George came, he was a soldier, and the legend was created in the early years of the Christianity, so it was about Roman years. So the legend has it that St. George went over to the mountain, he fought the dragon and threw him away. And later the king asked him, what do you want as a reward? You saved our land and my daughter, of course. So the saint asked him to build a church, and the church is built and stands in our country until now. This is the projects from Cyprus. I hope you enjoyed them. We just want to show you some traditional lessons.